My name is Elizabeth Phillips Apple Spencer Tobin. To the guest of honor, director, and other protocols observed, here is Nyamuge Standard 7 Science Club ready to present to you some experiments. I would like to welcome my colleague, as for science.
My name is Evans Tenga from Standard 7. I'm here to tell you what science is. Science, in its simplest definition, is the study of environment. Environment consists of living and non-living things, but today we are going to talk about non-living parts of the environment, but mostly about air. I would like to welcome my fellow colleague to talk more about air.
My name is Professor Walter Danford. I'm here to talk about air.
Jamani, tuongeze makofi hapo.
Air is the mixture of different gases. In air, it consists of different gases. For example, oxygen. The composition and percentage of oxygen is 21. Nitrogen, 78%. Carbon dioxide, 0.03. And other inert gases. Thank you. I would like to welcome my fellow colleague.
Huyo ni profesa na sisi tunasema na iwe hivyo. Anatamka jambo jema na sisi tunasema iwe hivyo.
My name is Maria Silvanus, a professor to be. Our first experiment is going to concern air pressure. What is air pressure? Air pressure is the weight of air on the Earth's surface. The materials that we are going to use in our experiment are bottle of water and pins.
Haya, hivyo ndivyo vifaa vitakavyokwenda kuonyeshwa kufanya tukio ambalo wanakwenda kufanya sasa hivi. Na huyu mama ni mwanadada na ni professor.
The first procedure, we are going to pin our pins on the bottle following the same depth. Second procedure, we are going to remove our pins. Ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, water did not move out. This is because the pressure outside the bottle is greater than the pressure inside the bottle. Then we are going to remove the top. As you can see, water spread out. This is because the pressure inside the bottle is greater than the pressure that is outside. Then this air pressure, we can apply it in our life. For example, air pressure, we can use it in helping the aeroplane to fly. Then also air pressure can be used in hospitals, in drips. Thank you.
Tuwapongeze kwa makofi na vigeregere. Wakati hewa ilikuwa haijafunguliwa maji hayakuweza kutoka, lakini ilipofunguliwa maji yakatoka. Na ilipofungwa maji yakanyamaza.
My name is Walter Danford. I'm here to present for you the second experiment. Our second experiment, the aim of our experiment is carbon dioxide formation. The materials used, there is acid, there is base, there is a bottle, a funnel, funnel, balloons, candle, matchbox, and thread. Procedures. Then our next procedure, connect the balloon with the bottle. Connect the balloon with the bottle. As you can see, they are connecting the balloon. Then lift the balloon so that you can transfer the base into the acid. Now you can see the balloon is being lifted upward. Means there is a gas that is produced, and the gas that is produced is called carbon dioxide. So yeah, this experiment has resulted into carbon dioxide. So you can see the carbon dioxide is being collected in the balloon. Then tie the balloon with the thread. Then remove it. So you can see what is produced here is what we call carbon dioxide. So here we have produced carbon dioxide. Properties of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is heavier than air. As you can see, you see it goes down. So carbon dioxide, that is one of its property. It is heavier than air. Another property, it extinguishes fire. Carbon dioxide can be used to extinguish fire. We are going to test so that you can see if it is true that carbon dioxide extinguishes fire.
Our dear visitors, we are very sorry the wind is so strong and therefore our candles cannot burn. Therefore, property or function of carbon dioxide to extinguish fire cannot take place effectively when wind is blowing. Therefore, bear with us due to the fact that there's strong wind prevailing. We are going to do another different experiment from this. You are most welcome and enjoy. Thank you.
So because of the carbon dioxide gas, it was said that it is the heaviest gas. So we are going to compare it with hydrogen. In our hydrogen formation, we need the hydrochloric acid, which is diluted with water. We need the zinc metal. We need a flat-bottomed flask. We need balloon, funnel. So those are going to be our items. Let's start. Procedures. Put some zinc inside the flat-bottomed flask by using a funnel. As you can see, they are trying to put the zinc inside the flask. After that, use another funnel to transfer the hydrochloric acid inside the flat-bottomed flask by using another funnel. Yeah. As you can see, they are transferring the hydrochloric acid inside the flat bottom flask. After that, tie a balloon so as to collect hydrogen gas that is formed when the hydrochloric acid is mixing with zinc. Because it is hydrochloric acid, this kind of reaction produces heat. Heat is gonna be produced in some time, but the hydrogen gas is collected. This kind of experiment that produces heat is called the exothermous reaction. You can see it takes a lot of time to collect inside the balloon, so just be patient. And properties of this gas, it burns with a pop sound. Just be patient. We are going to use our proper. I said that it burns with a pop sound. And this hydrogen is also the lightest gas. The lightest gas in the atmosphere is hydrogen gas. Also, this gas is used to make bombs. That hydrogen bombs at you. I told you that it burns with a pop sound. So even a bomb, when it explodes, it will produce a pop sound. That is why it's also used in making bombs. This is hydrogen gas. Also used in balloons at tourist national parks. If you have visited any national parks that contain these balloons, you can find some are using hydrogen. These are called weather balloons. Some are using hydrogen to fly so as to observe different situations occurring. Okay, when they made carbon dioxide, they said that carbon dioxide is the heaviest gas and hydrogen is the lightest gas. Let us prove it by submitting them in the air. We just submit them at one time. The one with the red balloon is carbon dioxide, white balloon is hydrogen. So let's try. This experiment can't go on because the hydrogen we collected is too small. So we're going to try to burn hydrogen to see if it produces a pop sound. Precaution. Wazazi, tulie, nikawa una pressure utulie. Maana hapa ni sauti ya bomu. Awa tuliza.
Hivi vitu vya milipuko ni hatari, inabidi mwalimu awe karibu kuhakikisha kwamba utaratibu mzima unafanyika na yeye kuwepo. Ndio maana katika masomo haya wanahakikisha kwamba wanafunzi wanapofanya na mwalimu anakuwepo kuhakikisha usalama wao na usalama wa vifaa vyenyewe. Mafunzo ya milipuko haya ni hatari sana. Kama mwalimu anashtuka. Basi jamani, hebu tuwapongeze kwa makofi kwa kazi kubwa ambayo wameonyesha hapo tangu walipoingia katika viwanja hivi ni kwamba milipuko yote inatokana na hewa, na wamechanganya hizo hewa kaboni na pamoja na nyingine hizo zote, na hatimaye tunapata milipuko kama hiyo.